Царства, Вышне, Святи, Роди, Берди, Шарболи, Бог Господа. Dear brothers and sisters, good morning to all of you. Welcome to our church. We are very grateful you are here today on this great feast day, such a good numbers. I wish I had full church every Sunday like this. Today we celebrate one of the great feast days of Christian calendar, the Feast of Palm Sunday. We decorate it to celebrate. We brighten things up with the color of green, and we gather together to celebrate Christ's entry into the city of Jerusalem. Today we celebrate Christ as a king who enters our own personal Jerusalem, our own hearts. Today's feast day is a momentary fast of joy and celebration, because tonight we begin the final part of the Lenten journey to Pascha. The mood changes from one of joy this morning to one of solemn sorrowful this evening, as we are led up to the great sacrifice that Christ performed for us on the cross. When Christ entered Jerusalem on the donkey, many of the people were disappointed and could not believe or imagine that the Messiah, who they believed was coming in, is riding on a little donkey and that he could save them. The Feast of Palm Sunday have been celebrated in our church since the earliest days of Christianity. But the use of palms in connection with the religious celebration goes all the way back to Old Testament times. Interesting that palm trees did not grow around Jerusalem, so the people would buy imported palms just like we did today. The palm branches were used as a visual tool proclaiming that God was the true King of the Israelites. Yesterday, Christ performed a miracle by raising Lazarus from the dead, the miracle that foreshadowing his glorious resurrection that we await for next Sunday. Now everyone is convinced that this is the Messiah King who will save the Israelites, or that Christ fulfills the prophecy of Zechariah entering Jerusalem on a little donkey. All of Israel is preparing to go to Jerusalem for the Feast of Passover, just as the Jewish people we know will be observing all this coming week. For the Orthodox Christians around the world, we celebrate these events as they happened, not only in the past, but as they also happen today. We celebrate Christ as a King who enters our hearts, our own personal Jerusalem. But is Christ able to enter? Is there a room for in our hearts for Christ to rule as a King? Are the doors of our hearts locked? Are our souls so filled with negativity and temptation that we have left no room for Christ to enter? And how do we solve the problem of letting Christ in or back into our lives? How do we tell ourselves or get the message that within ourselves the one thing is missing that could make our lives so positive and so worth living? The answer is to give yourselves to the will of God. Give God everything that keeps you from Him, from faith, from love, from harmony in your life with others and your families. Give your life to the one who gave you life. We are such prisoners to the temporal and ethereal things that fade and rust away, like the things of this world, society, culture, and life, as we call it in America. We have made ourselves prisoners of this world, of our careers, of money, of politicians who rule over us. We are even slaves to our own passions. The only way to find peace, to find true happiness, to experience true love, is to give yourselves to God. And make Him your King, live in total communion with Him and His teachings. And the way in which we turn our hearts from the kingdom of the self into the kingdom of God is through daily prayers, even if some days you only have time to cross yourself. Through reflection, frequent communion and confession, and reading and understanding the scriptures when you can. So many people complain that they cannot find time to come to church, they can't find time to pray and read the scriptures, they can't find time to fast or to go confession or communion. The reason they don't have time is that they are slaves to their own selves, to their own will. If we don't have time for God, then why? He should have time for us. But God always has time for us. He is constantly knocking at the door of our hearts, to our lives, and asking to come in. He is constantly waiting for our answer to His call and His invitation to a better life. Today, we receive our palm branches at the end of Divine Liturgy. Let us take them to our homes and place them somewhere where we can always see them. Let the palms remind us that Christ is the King of our families, that Christ is the King of our hearts, that Christ is the only true answer to happiness and meaning in our lives. And if we do proclaim Christ as our King, let us try and make for Him in our daily prayers. Let us be reminded that He is the one with whom we will be spending eternity. Let us be reminded that our careers, our education, our finances, our homes, and all the basic material needs in our lives are only temporary. Let us prioritize and place Christ the King as the primary concern in our lives, that not one day goes without thoughts of Him and His teachings. It is only when we have done this that we will find true peace and happiness in such a confused and complex world. Amen. Proslavljamo ulazak Gospoda Hrista u Jerusalim. Proslavljamo dan kada su deca i ljudi u gradu Jerusalimu dočekali sa palmovim grančicama i cvećim i rečima Osana, blagosloven koji dolazi u ime Gospodnje. Jerusalim je bio grad mira i dočekao je cara koji dolazi da donese mir. Cveti su, kao što rekao, radostan i tužan praznik. Radostan jer dolazi car slave, Hristos je pomalo tužan jer znamo da će on biti raspet na krstu. Jer se sjećamo reči Evanđelja koje kaže da Sin Boži treba da ide u Jerusalim i da postrada. Ali u krstu ponovo i jeste naša radost, jer kroz Hristovo stradanje mi se spasavamo, kroz Hristovu smrt mi dobijamo život i dobijamo oproštaj grehova. Mi danas treba da dočekamo Gospoda Hrista kao našeg cara, da ga dočekamo u srcima našim, i naše srce jeste naš Jerusalim i naš mir. Pitanje je da li je naše srce otvoreno i spremno da primi Hrista cara. Pitanje je da li našim srcem vlada neko drugi, da li smo ga opsednuli samim sobom i ne puštamo nikoga da uđe u njega. Zato smo dužni da priđemo sa palmovim grančicama mira i međusobne dobre volje. Dužni smo da ga sretnemo cvećem svojih plemenitih osjećanja, čiste ljubavi i radosnog raspoloženja. On nas očekuje da ga sretnemo iskreno i prosto srdačno, kao kada jerusalimska deca kličući nekada Osana, sinu Davidovu, nekad blagosloven koji ide u ime Gospodnje, Osana na visinu. I danas, kada ponesemo palmove grančice kući, treba da ih u svojim domovima stavimo na vidno mesto, da nas uvek opomenju da je Hristos naš car i onaj koji upravlja našom porodicom, našim srcem, da se opomenemo da samo u Hristu možemo biti srećni. Da nas palmine grančice opomenu da je prolazno, nestabilno i nesigurno i da je jedina sigurnost i sreća u Gospodu Hristu. Amin.
And the third day, through Jesus Christ of our Lord, with whom you are blessed together with your most holy good and love creating spirit now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
These palm branches and willows are blessed with the sprinkling of this holy water in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blagosiljaju se i osvećuju se ove palmine i vrbine grančice, kropljenjem ove osvećene vode u ime Otca i Sina i Svetoga Duha.
Amin.